after an early morning 11 a.m. kickoff, LSU closes out their season with a win over Texas A&M, 42-30. It was Jayden Daniels' last game in Tiger Stadium. So we're going to bring you the last Valley Vision Gameday vlog of the season. It's a little bit different because it's after the game, but we're going to get you some good content. Let's go. They're running away. I can't get a bartender to talk to me. Hey, why were they so scared to talk to me?
I don't know. I think that if I saw a girl like you at a bar, I'd come up to her no matter what.
Thank you. What's your name?
Cooper.
Would you rather an early kickoff or a late kickoff?
I think an early kickoff, to be honest.
Why?
Because you get the thing you have to do out of the way. Like, I'm like, now everyone can just go to Fred's. They don't have somewhere to go later. You can even go to sleep at 7:30.
That's my plan. All right, last question. Jayden Daniels Heisman, what are your thoughts?
I mean, if they don't give it to him, we know it's rigged. If he's a lock.
Y'all's outfit is a little bit different. Can y'all explain what y'all are wearing and why?
It's the wannabe referee tailgate.
The wannabe referee tailgate. Explain that. What is that?
It's a volleyball brand. It's called the Wannabes, and
So y'all know what TKN is, or who TKN is. Did you know they have a podcast with us?
Yes.
You knew that? He knew. He knew we hosted the TKN podcast. What are your thoughts on Jayden Daniels and the Heisman conversation?
He did all right. He should get it. I think he should get it.
He should get it?
Yeah, why not?
Why not? Because he's the best player in college football right now.
Yeah. All right. He's above average.
Last question. What are your thoughts on the team this season?
Above average.
Above average? Okay.
They're not Kristen Nuss good.
They're not Kristen Nuss good. Kristen, you heard that.
On defense.
Right? They need to take some notes from Kristen Nuss.
Kristen Nuss can teach them how to play defense.
The man.
Oh my God.
The myth.
Sorry.
The legend, Joe Mitchell. The guy who puts in all of the work behind the camera, who's put up with all the BS throughout the entire football season. He's got awesome college football insight. And I know you have a lot of thoughts on this team. First off, how'd you feel about that 11 a.m. kickoff?
I hate 11 a.m. kickoff, except unless it's in the Big Ten. The Big Ten noon game is always fun, but this one, not so much.
That's a little bit different. Yeah, we struggled to get out here this morning. I struggled. Let's talk about Jayden Daniels, Heisman. We know we've talked about it on the show, but after watching him, especially for the past 3-4 weeks, just continue to put up the numbers and continue to lead this team, what do you think needs to happen? Not what is going to happen, what do you think needs to happen?
Yeah, it's not close. Jayden Daniels deserves to be the Heisman. Look, he has 3 losses. So did Lamar Jackson. So did Johnny Manziel. So did Robert Griffin III. So did Tim Tebow. There's a number of guys to go to look at and say there's a precedent for a 3-loss Heisman. Look at the total yardage. Look at the passing yardage. He's not far behind Bo Nix in terms of passing yards. I want to say he's like 600 or 700 yards ahead of him in terms of total yards, because he's leading by like 800 or 900 yards more than him. It's not close. If it doesn't go to Jayden Daniels, it's a joke.
I was going to say, what do you think is going to be the one thing that keeps it out of his hands?
Maybe completion percentage. Bo Nix is a little bit ahead of him than that. They're also a one-loss team with a chance to avenge their loss to Washington. So if Oregon wins the Pac-12 championship next weekend, it's going to be hard to keep it from Bo Nix, from the voters' eyes, but Jayden deserves it.
Who do you want to see LSU play in a bowl game?
I would love to see LSU-Louisville. I think that'd be a great game. Honestly, USC has too many losses, but I think if you put LSU versus USC, the point total, that would be like 140.
That would be a crazy matchup.
And I'm exaggerating. It wouldn't be 140, but it would be a lot.
All right, overall thoughts on this season, good and bad. Leave your last remarks for the vlog.
Very fun. Look, obviously this is Valley Vision. I have a college football show. So as somebody who can look at it objectively, LSU has been the most divisive team to watch this year. There's not a better offense in the country, and there's very few worse defenses. So, like, you can watch an LSU game and be like, holy crap, this is elite football, and then in the next 2 minutes be like, this is bad football. So very fun to watch offensively as a fan, but I would like to see some changes going into next year. In my opinion, LSU wasted the offense that they had this year with that defense. And that's really unfortunate, but I'm grateful to have seen the offensive play we did.
Your favorite part of doing these vlogs this season?
All of the stuff that doesn't make the vlog. everything that gets removed, things that people ask us to take out. You see a lot of things doing this that that y'all don't get to see. So that's always fun for me.
What are your thoughts on Jayden Daniels?
Jayden Daniels deserves a chance at the Heisman voting. Bo Nix and Michael Penix have a good chance, but not many have put up the numbers that Jayden has. And our go Tigers.
Did you go to the game?
I did go to the game.
Okay, what are your thoughts on the game today?
That we played terrible most of the game.
Wait,
but
we won.
As in the fourth quarter.
Fourth quarter. So thoughts on Jayden Daniels in the Heisman contention right now?
I hope he wins it. I really hope he wins it.
He should, right?
He should. Absolutely.
And I know you have a little piece of wardrobe that you want to show off. So Lily's got a beautiful tiger tail here that she wanted to show. Hey, what did y'all do for the 11 a.m. kickoff? How'd you feel about that one?
It felt really good. We walked into Superior Grill at about 10:45, ate about a gallon worth of queso, four margaritas, had a fantastic time. Felt really great.
So what is your favorite thing about coming back to Baton Rouge on a game day?
If you've ever been to this place called Superior Grill, they have really great queso. I get about a gallon of it every time. Four margaritas, salt on the rim. It's a really great place. Highly suggested.
Hey, 11 a.m. kickoff. How do you feel about that?
Rough.
Very rough. What time did you start tailgating / drinking this morning?
I would say 7:30, but that would be a lie, so I'll say 7 a.m.
7?
Yeah, it was early.
Was it actually 7?
It was really 7.
What was your first drink?
Corona with tequila in the neck. It's called a Baja Fog. It's the only way to drink a Corona. You get the tequila in the neck, and then you chase it with the Corona.
That's one way to start an 11 a.m. kickoff.
It was fantastic.
Okay, so you went to the game.
Yes.
We pulled out a win, 42-30.
Yes.
Wasn't necessarily the prettiest win. What are your takeaways?
Well, you know, I think as always, our offense performs way better than our defense. Matt House should be fired. That may be a controversial statement. I think Malik Nabers, Jayden Daniels, and then Harold Perkins Jr. are carrying our whole team and are the only reason we are ranked.
Can't forget about Brian Thomas either.
Of course not. I forgot to mention Brian Thomas.
But between Malik Nabers and Brian Thomas, I believe they're the top two receivers. Or they have the most touchdowns, receiving touchdowns. 15 and 14, Joe is letting me know. They're up for some awards. And of course, Jayden Daniels is up for the Heisman. What are your thoughts on that one?
I think he should win the Heisman, but we all know he won't because of the way this whole scheme is rigged against us.
The Fred's ATM.
Chris is at the Fred's ATM because he has to take out cash. I'm not going to get your card info. I'll block it.
It's a scam just like the Heisman.
Where did you get these wonderful overalls?
I painted them myself at the start of the season.
You did it? Do you wear for every game?
Every game, yes, ma'am.
Every single game?
Yes, ma'am.
Obviously, they don't have too much good luck, though, huh?
They do.
Tough loss today. Jimbo Fisher's out. Who do you want to be your next head coach?
I'd love if we could get Lanning out of Oregon, but I don't think so. So I'd take Jeff Fish out of Arizona. I'd love Fish to be head of school.
Did you go to the game today?
I did go to the game.
What were your thoughts on Tiger Stadium?
I expected it to be louder, honestly. I was in Neyland earlier this year for the A&M Foles game. That was loud and rocking. Death Valley let me down.
Death Valley let him down. I'll give you, look, you got to cut us some slack. 11 a.m. kickoff is tough.
But what else are you going to do at 11 a.m. in a football game than drink?
He's got a point. Sam is one of the women I look up to in sports.
Don't you say that to me right now.
She's a badass. She's been around for years before I had the cool jobs and stuff. And she's been on my side and had my back through all of it. She actually set up one of the interviews that we're going to have on Valley Vision during the week. You got to wait to see that, though. How did it feel to be back in Death Valley?
It was beautiful. There's no place like it. I've been to a lot of stadiums in my day, a lot of football games in my day. There's nothing like it. It was great. Okay, overall, we've done a lot of growing. Defense is a bit rough. We need to work on that. Situational play calling is interesting, but I'm appreciating it. I'm enjoying it. All I know is that there's a Heisman out there, and it's my Heisman. So
that was the next question I was going to ask. Jayden Daniels clearly should win the Heisman.
Clearly.
Is it rigged? Is he going to win it, though?
I don't believe in anything being rigged out there. I believe in the system. Ask anyone, I believe in the system. However, I do think he's going to win. I think he's clearly the front runner. I think there's a couple other guys out there that are doing their thing. But I think all around, everybody knows what's up.
Favorite part about college football?
Oh, I think it's unlike anything else except for maybe European soccer in the sense of fandom. And I think especially in the South, especially in the SEC, that's kind of where we started it all. So I'm saying the undying fandom. That's where I'm at.
I love that. 11 a.m. kickoff. How early did you start drinking?
Oh, God. There was a fireball shot in my living room at 7:15 this morning.
So did you go to the game today?
Yeah.
You did? What were your thoughts?
I thought Jayden Daniels won the Heisman Trophy.
That's been everybody's
response. I mean, he had to put an exclamation mark to end the season off, and because Bo Nix has a chance to win it as well. So I think he did that exclamation mark today.
So you think today was the ceiling game? He wins that trophy on
100%.
December 9th? Definitely, for sure.
Yeah, if I were to bet, Vegas has it.
Nard. All right, Nard, I gotta get you in the vlog.
All right, get me in the vlog.
Nard is an OG from when I used to bartend at Bogey's. He used to come see me all the time. What'd you drink, Bacardi and OJ?
The Bacardi, Nardy juice.
Bacardi and OJ. All right, did you watch the game?
Yeah, I watched. What I was at the game.
What were your thoughts?
I knew they were gonna come out on top of the fourth quarter. I really wasn't worried. I just had all the little Texas A&M fans in my neck, but they shut up after the third quarter was over.
What do you think is going to happen with the Heisman?
Oh, Jayden all the way.
You think Jayden's got it?
I put my last dollar on him.
You put your last dollar on Jayden Daniels?
Most definitely.
How much are you going to make if he wins?
Probably about $3,000.
$3,000 if Jayden Daniels wins the Heisman. Good luck to you.
Thank you.
They're giving out Dos Equis right now, so of course, I got to try it because I've never had a Dos Equis before, right? Hi, ladies. How are y'all today? What's your favorite part about Death Valley?
To be honest, I don't like football.
Who is your favorite player on the football team?
Jayden Daniels.
You knew it. Is he going to win the Heisman?
Hopefully.
Hopefully. Dos Equis has a lime and salt. Okay, explain this. What is this?
It's the Dos Equis with lime and salt.
Dos Equis, lime and salt. I'm trying it right now. It's exactly what it says on the can. I don't know why I asked that question. It's lime and salt and Dos Equis, so. It's actually really good, and it's exactly what you think it would taste like, Dos Equis, lime and salt.
At Valley Vision, I see the future. I see the vision. And I see that they're going to be a prominent Baton Rouge. Not only Baton Rouge, actually. This will just be like Canes. You know, Canes got their start in Baton Rouge, right over there, the mothership. And so Valley Vision, just as similar as Canes, will get their start right here in Baton Rouge and will expand. I'm thinking more SEC schools. I'm thinking Big Ten, Pac-12, all of them. The Ohio State, where Joe Burrow, where they try to claim Joe Burrow.
Okay, so wait. She's pitching sponsorships, and we appreciate you because we need sponsorships. We know it, but you bring that up. Ohio State tries to claim Joe Burrow.
See, the thing is, Joe Burrow was on Ohio State's practice squad, and Joe Burrow would not have the chance that he did at LSU to become a Heisman winner, the second from LSU. And I'm just saying, LSU gave him his platform. Just like Valley Vision is giving LSU the platform to take off right here.
I can't talk about Heisman. Uh-oh.
Oh my
God. We have a visitor.
God.
What's your name?
Isaac.
Okay, Isaac, you look like you have something to say.
Oh, yeah, I got a lot to say.
All right, you go ahead.
Okay.
First things first.
All right.
Rest in peace, Uncle Phil.
Okay.
Rest in peace, Jimbo Fisher.
Thank you.
Rest in peace, Jimbo. What do you have to say about your loss today to LSU?
I respect all of them. I hope all of them get to find love.
One day.
I want all of them to be together.
Can I get your thoughts on y'all's loss today?
Look up the last couple years.
And y'all still lost. It's 2023. It's this year.
No, she asked, what are your thoughts?
On this loss.
This loss.
Who do you want to replace Jimbo Fisher?
Who cares? I don't care.
I hate y'all.
So in the clip before this,
yes,
this gentleman was giving everybody a show.
That happens every now and then.
Okay,
yeah.
So what got you to do that? What made that happen?
I was born as a wrestler, right? So I got a pretty good bond.
Taking over, this is Cali Photo featuring on Valley Vision. So, sir, how are you feeling about this win against A&M?
You know, they won by 12, but I really needed them to win by 12 and a half.
Oh, what'd you have, the spread or something?
Yeah, minus 12 and a half, and they won by 12, so.
You need that half a point, which doesn't exist, right?
I might not be able to pay my mortgage this week.
And that's okay, because the Tigers still won, I guess.
They did win. And the over in passing touchdowns and over in rushing touchdowns hit.
It hit? Did you have it?
Yeah, I did. My kid's going to have a Christmas this year. He almost didn't.
How many kids do you have?
Four.
Oh. What about to the Heisman Selection Committee? What do you want to say to them?
I'm very financially invested in Jayden Daniels winning the Heisman this year. We got him at plus 1,600, so would love for Jayden Daniels doing the Heisman. Fourth kid will get a Christmas present if Jayden Daniels wins the Heisman.
I gotta get this one. Callie did your interview first because I was in the restroom. Why do you have a home button on your phone?
I've actually paid a lot of money to maintain the home button. I've probably broken my phone like 9 times over the last like 2 years, and I just pay to get it fixed because I like the home button.
Wait, no, are you just trying to be different?
No, I just like the home button. I don't know, I don't think I'd be able to operate like a new iPhone. Like, people will give me their phone to play music, and I don't know what to do.
So how long do you plan on keeping that home button?
We're at the ass end of this phone. Like, it is on its last legs.
Yeah. Can I click it? I just want to click it.
And I think everyone and their mother should watch Valley Vision, personally. Especially your mother. She's a wonderful lady.
Yeah, Jenny. Yeah.
Jenny. Jenny's a wonderful lady. Jenny is sponsoring Valley Vision. Shout out Jenny.
She doesn't know it yet. But.
She doesn't know it, but hey, she's getting a Valley Vision. I owe you $300,000. Is that correct?
Amen.
Who's your favorite player on the football team?
Jayden Daniels, for sure. Jayden Daniels for the Heisman.
How did you get to Fred's?
I rode in a pedicab.
How much did that cost?
$10. It was worth every fucking cent.
Only $10?
Only $10. Yeah, shout out to our local businesses, you know?
How many people were on the pedicab?
It was three. There was two long bitches, you know, that was in the pedicab. He was like really struggling. I'm not gonna lie, I thought we lost like at first, and it wasn't until like a lot longer afterwards that I realized that we won. But y'all have to understand there's a 50-50% chance that I was right.
Who's your favorite player on the team?
Joe Burrow.
No. Kylie was at our live show at Modesto.
I was. The best thing I've ever seen in my entire life.
The best thing you've ever seen ever. In your entire
ever.
Life. Okay, so
ever.
Big Valley Vision fan. Thoughts on Jayden Daniels winning the Heisman?
Is there even like a question about it?
There
like,
shouldn't be.
Like there should not be any.
He no, should win, right?
Yes. Yeah.
Favorite player on the team?
Abby, you can't throw that. Favorite former player, Joe Burrow.
Another one.
All right, y'all know we do a shotgun segment every week. Oh, this isn't going to be good.
You want me to help?
No.
I'll just take this one.
Hey, what's up? So this is not your normal size beer. It may take a little bit longer.
Yes.
Three, two, one.
False start, number 15, offense.
Okay, so normally we're at the tailgates trying food. We didn't go to tailgates today because it was an early kick. They have a killer food truck. These tater tots, fire. Tater tots are fire. They have so much good food. That's not tailgate food, but I mean, we're talking about Louisiana culture. I feel like this plays, if you're gonna go to a bar in Tigerland, Fred's is it. If you're gonna get food in Tigerland, it's probably that food truck over there. It's called the Munchin' Moose. They're doing it right here. If you've been to Fred's, you know they're ahead of the game. Tater tots are fire, 10 out of 10. Sorry, I'm finishing my last tater tot. I like your Pit Vipers, first off.
Pit Vipers are a way of life. I thought that we won convincingly. However, could we have used another touchdown to make Jayden, you know, over the top?
Right.
I would have appreciated it.
You needed an exclamation point on the Heisman conversation, right?
Yes, and I think that there's a period there, not an exclamation point, and that's what scares me. The numbers don't lie. So, when I was in college, we had Joe Burrow. Yeah. And I was here before I graduated. It was his first year. And he threw for, what, 2,000 yards? You know, like 15 touchdowns, something modest. And if you would have seen me that season and been like, yeah, Joe Burrow for Heisman, I would have been like, no. Bo Nix, all he has going for him is a very high completion percentage. Other than that, Jayden Daniels takes him to school.
Make it an all-day festival after the game. So it used to be the kiss of death. Like, we'll have an 11 a.m. game. I would, like, throw a little temper tantrum. But in 2017, I think it's 2017, we played in Arkansas, and it was our second busiest game of the year. I came to Baton Rouge for 3 days in 79 and never left. Fell in love with Baton Rouge. And from Miami to college in New Orleans, worked in college bar, came for 3 days, and here we are.
Here you are, yeah.
I have my grandchildren here today.
What did you think about us winning our last game of the season?
We won.
What is y'all's favorite part of an LSU game day?
You go, babe.
Probably hearing the song. Oh, it's playing right now. What's
Call
it called?
Colin
Baton Rouge.
That's that your was favorite a, part?
Yes. When you hear it in the stadium and everyone's just going crazy, it's my favorite.
That it is.
This is my first football game ever.
Yeah,
well, college football game, first college football game ever, and I don't know how I'm gonna top this.
What better way to spend it than an LSU football game?
I know, it was amazing.
It's gonna be really hard to top an LSU football game.
I know, I loved it.
All right, guys, this was it. This was the last football game day vlog of the season. LSU had some ups and downs. We've been with you for every Saturday home game. You've seen it all firsthand, all the tailgates on the parade grounds, the nights at Fred's, the interviews, it's been everywhere. But I just wanna say that we appreciate you guys for sticking with us, for helping us build this community. We don't know where it's going, we have a vision for it, and we're super excited. We appreciate y'all's support, and we will see y'all soon.